Hello, hello, back again. We actually wanted to make now the video for 12,000 subscribers, but we decided we will make it and we go for 20,000 and we will reach it very soon and then we make a nice video for 20,000. So today actually there is a someone asked something about buzzing on instruments, and there are many buzzes, and the one is when the top or the back is loosening up. But another buzz, a different buzz, is actually with the empty string when you just pick the string without bow. That's why I don't play now here a nice piece of Mozart. With the bow you don't really hear the difference that much, but it is something which me as a maker, I immediately hear it and I ask, can I see your instrument? I look and then, and the empty string is not clear. And that's mainly caused of the upper nut, that the string is at the departure towards the bridge, not tight at the edge of the upper nut, and so it's lying a little bit loose and is vibrating in this first 1 or 2 millimeters still on the upper nut is already vibrating too much, so that it makes a certain buzz. And that's something caused by the wrong shape of the upper nut. So to my apprentice and everybody who shows up and wants to show me an instrument here in Cremona, it's very often that people just make something and then they ask, and even today there was a colleague of mine asking me, Edgar, can I pass by and show you? And this is something we're exchanging our things here in town, and even me myself, sometimes I take my instrument if I'm very proud and then I go to some colleagues, Vladimir or Daniele or Stefano or whatever, you know. And it's always nice to talk about, and sometimes I made some barbecuing at my house and I invited some violin makers, but it's already many years ago, should actually repeat even that one. Anyhow, so when I see that, then I tell them that they have to create the upper nut in a way that the changing of the direction of the string, when the string comes into the peg box, is made on the upper nut, in order that the turn is made in that tiny area of 4 or 5 millimeters, sometimes a little bit more, of this tiny piece of ebony. And if this shape is not perfectly done, then it causes this buzz. Now, I know you want it just immediately and quick, but since every string goes in a different angle to its peg in a different direction, so you cannot make them all the same, because the pegs are all a little bit different and then a little bit in different positions, every single string has a different shape. And these four different shapes create the shape of your entire upper nut. So what for some people is just somewhere where there are these notches and the strings go into the back box and you don't care how it is made from a factory instrument, if it's well done, it's great and everything is fine. But if it's not correct, it creates an incredible annoying buzz, which drives you crazy, and we want to avoid that. So I show you now one, because on Saturday, 1st May, I had here an American searching for a violin, and at the time I explained them everything because he was somehow attracted of all my different lines of instrument and things like this. I happened to pick one of these Scala Perfetta, which are rather low-graded instruments, and I found one where this is not correct, and now I just have to search it and then I show you. Yeah, it is this one. I don't know if you can you hear that already a little bit? No, it's not tuned.
this. It's a little. I hope you can hear that. I tried to show you.
What we're talking is here when the string is turning, okay? Now I show you here writing it down, because once you know it, you will, sorry, these are my thickness secrets here on the violin top and here on the back. So
we have to design here straightforward the fingerboard edge and the upper surface of the fingerboard, okay? And then we have here our upper nut, right? And we're talking here about the string is coming here, let's say, like this. And then you can already tell how it should be here, right? So we're talking about this small turn, okay? And this is, when you see it from the upper side, I have to knee down in order that you can see that, right? We have the fingerboard here, and then we have here our upper nut, and here it goes towards the peg box, okay? And so we have here our green four strings. I hope I designed them very well. And so they come here without the ruler, pretty good. And now the first peg would be this one, right? So we decided here, we put it here. The first peg actually is the G string, sorry. So we make it here. It's a little bit, I exaggerate here with the cone. Okay. And the next peg is here somewhere. Now we cross over to the next. But what is the point is that the E string goes here to this area in the peg box, okay? And the G string goes here to this area, okay? So they rather go a little bit straight or a little bit open up. Okay, or sometimes go a little bit inside, it depends on the peg box, okay? While this string here goes up here and goes a little bit out, so goes a little bit inclined, now I exaggerate, okay? In order that you can see it, and this one goes to the third string up here and is like this. So you have like this, 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 and that. Exaggerated, certainly, how this goes from the upper side. From the side view, now we have to make some area here, some place. From the side view, we have here our scroll, right? And then, wow, what a fancy scroll here, huh? With five turns more than it is usually. And then here it goes like this, and then here's the neck. It's a little bit of thin net, but this is good. And then we have here our holes. These are a little bit more closer, a little bit larger, and then once again closer. So if you have now the fingerboard, we made blue, right? So we make it here. Here it is straight up, and then is here the fingerboard. Yeah? And so in this area, we have our upper nut, this here. And if you have now a string which comes here, you certainly can see that this one here goes up and then turns and then goes. But the same you cannot make for the A string, for instance. For the A string, this is not in this direction, but it is in this direction. And for this one, it's almost the same, but slightly different. And this one is a little bit less. So we have 1, 2, and 3 inclinations, which are more or less the same, but it's compared on where it is, a different radius here. And these 4 radius here create the shape of this upper nut. And then how you finish it at the very end, that you go down all the way here and you do something like this and you make it nice and it looks that it is apparently following the side of the fingerboard, is another issue. And that's actually only more beauty. And if it is nicely made, it is nice to touch and to look at, and that's what you actually see by your eye. But what really matters and what creates the shape of the upper nut is the right angle here, okay? And if it is wrong, and it is in the very last area here a little bit too flat, then it creates a D. And it's here not very strong, but I can hear it. And now we go over there and I attach it and I change it a little bit and you will see how it should be correct. And while we go over there, just think about Edgar wants 20,000 subscribers, okay? This is very important. So tell your friends. So,
did you tell already all your friends?
Now I want to show you how this is changed. I need some tools for that. Ordnung ist das halbe Leben, is my mother who told me. Everything in order is half of your life, and that's why I'm such a messy guy here. It's not true, but I find all my tools. Hold on, I just need some small files. Name, name, croci, punti, punti. Da, da, da. Ah, okay, here. Okay. Already worried that I don't find it. This is lime capo tasto. Okay, lime capo tasto means files for the upper nut. And here I have a lot of files, actually for every kind of string. Now, if I had a few years ago an apprentice who was always trying to give its best, and since a good apprentice is even better than the master, measured the size of the strings and then measured the files exactly and then made it, which is very nice. But if it's too perfect, the string then is kept too hard in the upper nut, in these slots. We made a video about slots on the bridge, and it's a little bit the same thing also on the upper nut. If it is too precise and the string is kept, it certainly doesn't make a buzz. But one of the vibrations of a string is up and down, left and right, and everything, but also is a rotating movement. And if you keep that movement, the instrument for the very first part of the string doesn't vibrate as free as it should be. So I wouldn't exaggerate. Now, don't make it 3 millimeters if the string is 0.5 millimeter. But don't exaggerate. So now, usually I have these files which you can purchase here. These ones are made from an Austrian or German company, Pechar-Rasps.com, and he has them in all sizes. You see this, there's even the address and there is the measurement. This one is for 1.1 millimeter, which means that it is 1.1 millimeter thick. And there's nothing on here, but just here there is a little bit of file. So if you put it like this, you can nicely make your notches super precise. Once they are done like it is on a finished violin, usually then I just loosen up the string and I take a, we call it coda di topo, the mouse tail. It's a very thin file like this. On the very end it is like not even half a millimeter, maybe even thinner. And you have it in different sizes. And this one here for even for cello, and here also for cello, yeah. And with these ones, then at the very end I go inside here and I give you some more light, and you see that this one is actually not very deep here. And you, when you look very precise, you see that it's how much it is touching here, and here actually nothing, very little. So I try to go into here, in this area here, and where it is actually too high, I go down and I go exactly where it should be. And I go inside here. By taking away here, it will be kept and will be lying strong on the very end where it is creating this buzz, right? Now don't look at the A string, which is really an old A string, and this one try to not to look at, thank you very much, okay? Now everybody's looking at this one, I know, but we use these strings for the first sound check, and then before the customer gets the instrument, it gets new strings, you know. Yeah, it's a little bit like this. It's already getting better. I can see it with my free eye that it is not enough. So, now let me see if I put this string inside. Usually then I put some pencil mark, pencil inside, some graphite, in order that it is better. This is actually already much better if I look at it. And but I will loosen, I will go a little bit more, a little bit more. Huh? It's just that I, maybe this one here is on the very end a little bit rougher, goes a little bit stronger. This one is a little bit finer. Now I replace it just to see if it is correct now. This is nice. And then I put some pencil inside. Some, usually I have the pencil with my name on it. Today I don't see it, so I take another one. Okay. So I put some pencil inside. This graphite makes that this string is slipping a little bit easier. Okay. And then I put this in here. Just want to get it a little bit butter. Oops. Oops, this is completely far away from being tuned. Huh? Non ho l'acqua. I cannot hear a wow, wow, wow or something. And if I look at the shape of this upper nut. I'm on the G string here, focus on the G string now, then I'm very happy about this here. Okay, can you see that? And maybe Anna can make a video where she can show you this shape a little bit in one direction and in another one. Hmm? Okay, so now you see that this string arrives, and from this point on, here is the changing of the direction, and from here it's straight and goes away. And this is perfect, the string is lying on it perfectly, and this is how it should be. I hope we discovered even today a small tiny difference and a small tiny part of which influences the great sound of an instrument. It's useful for you. You can adjust your instrument. Leave your comment. I promise you I will sit down and answer to your comments. I'm a little bit late in answering, but I'm doing my best. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, tell your friends, and remember, 20,000 is our next aim. And thank you for the 12,000. Ciao, ciao.